Hey guys, Game Prime here. Welcome back to more Let's Play Sly 3 Honor Among Thieves. Last time, we took on the Hazard Room, and before that, if you're skipping to here, we finished Rumble Down Under, defeated the Mask of Dark Earth, and got the Guru on our team for the first time in Cooper history. A new member has joined. So, let's start my favorite episode in this entire game, Flight of Fancy.
Was obsessed. Every night he'd pore over the blueprints to Dr. M's fortress, looking for a way to get into the Cooper vault. He soon came to the conclusion that there was no way inside unless the gang picked up a dedicated RC specialist, an expert who had mechanical and piloting skills far exceeding his own. After weeks of searching techie chat rooms, he finally found someone who could keep up with him intellectually. A gearhead genius out of Holland named Penelope. She politely declined our invitation to join the team, saying she only works for the best. Apparently, her idea of the best was her boss, the Black Baron, a big-time dogfighting champ up there in Holland. He's so good that he's even set up an international competition called Aces to attract worthy opponents. A few days later, she sent us a counteroffer. If our gang could manage to beat the Black Baron at his own game, then she'd know we weren't just a pack of jokers, and therefore, worth her time. So, we got busy. With no time to lose, Bentley and Murray worked to put a plane together, while I got my pilot license the fastest way possible. We'd prove to this Penelope that the Cooper gang was up for the challenge, even if we were making it all up as we went along.
Sly Cooper and the gang in Flight of Fancy, my favorite episode in this entire game. Oh my god, this is so good. I can't. So we are here in Kinderzijk, Holland. Carmelita's here. We are also here. There's a guru. And the safe house right over here. Something that bothered me as a little kid. You cannot choose Guru from the safe house. So that is unfortunate, but you will get to play as him more in this game. Anyway, let's check out ThiefNet, see what's up over here. We got the Adrenaline Burst, Health Extractor, Hover Pack. This is a move I'm buying right now. This is one of the best moves in the game. You need this for a job we're doing in a few videos. We're going to get this now. That's amazing. Paraglider, or Paraglide in this game. Another great one that you do need. Rocket Boots is also amazing. I'm not going to get that just yet because I'm broke. So, we are getting our costume on. Heading into the lobby. Now, funny fact about this costume. You cannot choose it alongside your Venice costume, and here we are.
If we're gonna succeed in this year's Aces competition, we'll need to learn who we're flying against.
What? They keep the flight roster a secret?
Correct. In years past, competitors would go out at night and sabotage each other's planes in preparation for the next day's dogfight.
I get it. So now they keep the lineup a secret, and no one knows who to mess with.
Precisely. Looks like you're a good pilot, but we've only got one plane, and you'll be up there against dozens of bogeys.
You know, normally I'd make some sarcastic remark about how overwhelmed I am by your confidence in me, but those are some grim odds. And, well, you know, I'm always up for some sabotage.
Glad to hear it. Now, the roster is kept secret from the pilots, but not from the event staff.
Do we have a mole on the inside?
Our friend, Dimitri, has been hired to give color commentary during the dogfights. He'll know where the roster's hidden. Scout him out somewhere in the hotel lobby. But be careful. If you start a fight with the other pilots, we'll be kicked out of the competition.
Sure. We all play nice until tomorrow. Then we blow each other to bits at 300 feet.
So, you can't run in this costume or whatever. The music is a nice remix of Dimitri's theme. That's something I didn't figure out until recently, actually. This is... I don't know. But, here's some pictures of Black Baron. We gotta go talk to Dimitri, by the way. He is down here somewhere. There he is.
Dimitri, funny seeing you here. Never pegged you as a flyboy.
Like a dance floor with many lights. I have many profiles. Dig, don't even try to understand the silky enigma of Dimitri.
Bentley seemed to think you might have a copy of the Aces flight lineup. That true?
And why should I talk to a two-bit Rudy Boot cracker box like you? Question mark in bold. Why?
Looks like I'll need to intimidate him a little. Maybe I should threaten violence? Use a logical argument? Or threaten to expose him? So, once again, I'm going to see... Or I'm going to show you guys every option here. There will be an option on screen to skip to the right answer. Let's threaten violence.
Listen, pal. We both know who will win in a fight between the two of us. I'm not looking to start something here, but you know I'll finish it.
True that, raccoon. In the mano a mano, you win. But look around, you soft sock. It's a supersized aviator blowout. Start a fight in hotel, and disqualification will be yours. You want that, Jack?
You might want to think about talking, pal. I could always rat you out to the Black Baron. Then you'd be out of a job.
I'd have no job, and you'd have no another flight lineup. Go ahead, blow that whistle. I'll be seeing you in the loser's hot dog banquet.
We both know you're gonna tell me. You wouldn't have bothered showing up if you didn't want to talk. So, spill it.
I know, but to talk is like sitting on an electric chair. The Baron has eyes. Eyes and ears. Ears and fists. Dimitri will be discovered, and the jig is pinched.
This guy's paranoid. Looks like I need to calm him down a little. Maybe I should compliment him. Make him feel good. Swear to keep it all a secret. Or promise to protect him. Click here to skip to the right answer.
You talk and the secret stays between us. I am a thief after all. Keeping things quiet is what I do best.
Trust a band of thieves? Do I look chumpy to you? Your promises will be cold comfort when I'm pushing up the daisies with concrete overshoes.
If you talk, me and the gang will protect you. We're all in this together. You can count on us. You know our reputation.
The Black Baron is a big wheel. He'll roll all over us. Too many men he commands. We can't stop them. Too many to count.
Come on now, Dimitri. A man like you can deal with this Black Baron. You've got the best fashion sense of anyone I know.
The fashion? Style? You're right. If I can outdress him, I can certainly outsmart him. all is told through clothes. Okay, I'll talk a flight lineup if you agree to owe Dimitri a favor, which I'll collect in a few months of time.
A favor?
This no small time favor, like, will you water my fish or feed my plant? No way, bro! This old school mafia blood pack favor, like movies, big time.
This guy's a real nut job. Not sure I wanna owe him. I could agree to the favor, refuse, offer him a bribe. Let's refuse.
No dice. I'm not in the habit of racking up debts, and I don't plan on starting now.
No dice, no debt, no aces flight lineup. The choice is yours. Take debt and take flight roster. Otherwise, take away nothing.
Would a few coins maybe change your mind? I find it's a lot easier to talk when I'm rich.
Bribe money? Libling? Cash won't help me get done what needs getting done. I need Gang of Thieves, not Federal Reserve.
Okay, Dimitri. Hook me up with the flight roster, and we'll owe you one.
Done! The bargain she has struck. To find flight roster, look behind one of the tacky paintings in Black Baron's air hangar. It's hidden in secret safe.
Art decryption lock, huh? I know just the guy for the job.
Stand cool. Here comes Big Cheese.
I bid you all a most flamboyant welcome, my esteemed comrades of the skies. Welcome, welcome to another year of the Aces competition. We've got teams here from across the globe. Canada, Belgium, Ecuador, Iceland, Korea, and many, many more. Not the least of which is last year's deadly runner-up, Team Mugshot.
This time, we're gonna drill you jokers full of holes.
Now, we all know that in years past, some teams have engaged in a little good-natured late-night hijinks.
Like when Team Canada stole Ecuador's parachutes.
Or when Team Iceland saw the landing gear off Korea's planes.
Or when Portugal put rat poison in Team Mugshot's coffee machine.
Yes, yes, that was all so very funny, but no more. You know the rules. No one, absolutely no one, is to leave the hotel after sunset. If my guards catch you outside, you will be beaten to within an inch of your life. No exceptions! This will be a fair competition!
Same as last year and the year before! I've got the scars to prove it!
I bid you all an exuberant and exaggerated farewell, pilots. Tonight, sleep like geese. And tomorrow, soar like eagles!
And we're off. So we gotta get out of here. As you saw, he's not up here anymore, but Mugshot is back. It'd be a very bad thing for the gang. And we head outside to continue the job. So we have to get to Black Baron's castle. These are the flashlight guards. Those are the spotlights. Don't get caught. Don't get caught. You son of a bitch. Yeah, there's a wolf here, by the way. This is the paraglider, by the way. Those are spotlights, by the way. That's another small guard. These guys throw wrenches. They're kind of annoying. Oh my god. Die, you stupid son of a bitch. Here's the castle.
Should
Gotta climb it now. I always enjoy doing this. I thought it was a very cool platforming segment. Make sure your controllers aren't broken, because you're going to need them for this part. You can get caught here, by the way. I ain't going to show it. But you definitely can get caught. Get on these pipes here. And
Sly. Hey, Sly. Sly, are you out there?
Nope, sorry. Just us Black Bear and goons.
Throw the switch and lower the drawbridge so that I can get up there.
Sorry, pal. I don't see any switch.
But there just has to be a switch. I can't get in the Baron's hangar from down here.
Hold on, I got an idea. It's gonna fall.
Medieval, but effective. Thanks, pal.
Sure thing. See you back at the safe house.
Bentley time. So we come over here, use this little catapult. Fling ourselves up here. These boxes have a lot of good chunk of coins in them. So go and destroy them if you want some coins. And we're headed in.
If Dimitri's intel is accurate, the flight roster should be locked behind one of the paintings in this hangar.
Okay, so it's one or the two, one of the two. I think there's only two. Don't make sure you platform on these planes, because you're not gonna make it. So we have the code right here, 223. Very easy. And nothing. So we'll destroy these, get some coins. Now the, what's it called? The hover pack. It extends your jumps while you're hovering in the air. Press X to do more jumps. So it's the best move in the game for Bentley. They sadly took it out of Sly 4. Because I like this one a lot better. Before we go over there, there's a lot of stuff here we could get a lot of coins from. So we're up to 600 again. I could probably get those rocket boots for Sly. TV over here. TV doesn't give you nothing. So let's see where the code is in this one. This one's always a little bit more trickier for me. 510. Yeah, we got the Aces team roster. And job complete. Meet you guys back at the safe house.
Okay, fellas. According to the Aces flight lineup, we'll be flying against Team Iceland and Team Belgium in tomorrow's semi-final round. As you're all aware, we've only got a single plane. While our opponents will be flying 15 apiece. You got that, guys? That's 30-1 odds against us. In order to give us a fighting chance, we'll need to pit these two teams against each other. First, Murray and Sly will paddle through the sewers beneath town to get access to an air vent leading into Team Iceland's hotel room. Steal one of their trademark Viking helmets, then head over to Team Belgium's hangar. Vandalize one of in order to frame Team Iceland for the damage. Next, Murray and I will steal one of Team Belgium's monogrammed handkerchiefs. Meanwhile, the Guru will break into the Team Iceland supply truck carrying their lucky ice sculpture. Sly will steal the art and then place the handkerchief insinuating Team Belgium for the crime. Get it? We frame both teams so they'll be gunning for each other and not Sly in the semifinals. All the while, I'll be setting up defenses around the Team Cooper air hangar. You never know when one of the other teams might come looking to do us some harm.
Okay, so we have two more jobs to do in this video. It's probably going to be a pretty beefy video. And then next video will probably be pretty beefy too. So let's go get Sly his rocket boots because I really want them. So we are going to do frame Team Belgium right now, and that is that one over there. Yep. So the rest are Murray jobs, it looks like. This guard has some loot. Ah, Christ. He didn't even see me. I'm right here, hi. I want to go get this guy's stuff. Got a silver medal. We're going to go put the rocket boots on right now. We love these things. So, what am I doing? Belgium? It's right there. Duh. Forgot how I get up there. Can't do that. Okay, it's right up here.
Good thinking. Team Iceland won't be gunning for me if they think the Belgians stole their lucky hunk of ice.
Well, that's the idea. Now the first thing to do is steal one of Team Belgium's official gold lace monogrammed handkerchiefs. Murray will head inside and get one of those stodgy Belgians laughing. They're notoriously stone-faced. Then I'll move in and steal the handkerchief.
Seems like getting inside that truck might be a good job for the Guru. He could use some of the guards' heads to bash in the back doors.
Agreed. I'll make sure he's in position.
Okay, so this is a very much a multiple part job. So Murray can automatically run in this costume. You don't have to hold down R1 or anything. He could just do one basic jump. You can't double jump. This poor sucker's our target.
Hello, Belgium Flyer. Do you like comedy? I think it's time for Mr. Salty Pants to crack a smile. What do you say?
I need to get this sourpuss laughing. I should try historical humor, an impression, political humor. Okay, so I think this is one where you just gotta go through a bunch of them, so. click here to go to the right.
What was Genghis Khan's favorite meal? The brains of his enemy. Get it? I mean, it's more weird and gross than funny, but I mean, you gotta admit, it's pretty weird. That Baron, he's always, I love flying. Don't go outside. Listen to me. I'm so smart. I'm the boss. My mustache is so macho. That's pretty lame, huh? Why did the chicken cross the road to France? Because it wasn't turkey. And you see, the chicken's not a turkey or a Turk. It's a chicken, a French hen. I can't make heads or tails of this coin. Get it? It's totally funny because, like, when you flip a coin, it comes out either heads or tails. Come on, that's comic gold. Ever see someone put their fist down their throat? Ta-da! Hey, fish! Duck! I need help! Hey!
Okay, Bentley, it's go time. Make the pull while the Belgian's laughing, or he's sure to feel you fishing for the handkerchief.
Alright, so we gotta go pickpocket this guy, only when it's lighting up, though. And we got the Belgian hanky.
Nice work. Meet me outside with the goods. It's up to the guru now. Bentley's en route to me with the monogrammed handkerchief, but we'll never be able to swipe the ice sculpture unless we can get into that armored truck. I agree. The back door should be its weak spot. Yeah, I'm sure the guards around here won't mind too much if you break the door down with their heads. Bentley set up a waypoint on the truck. Should be handy. The thing's moving pretty fast.
Okay, guru time. We gotta go get a few guards. So there's a few suckers here that are good for, right for picking. The rabbits move the quickest, by the way. So you're gonna want to take them, ram them into the back of the truck. Get on this guy. They run pretty fast, but not as fast as the bunnies. So now there's traps. Laid down by the truck. This truck freaking goes everywhere, though. Like, seriously. It goes around the entire map. You son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. Really? This is one of those jobs where it's gonna take some time because there's a lot going on, you know. And I'm sorry that this is going to be such a beefy episode. I didn't really look at the jobs crap that well when I was planning this out on a Word document. Or Google Doc, I should say. Because I do everything on Google Docs. The school has got me into the habit of that. So we need two more assholes. One's right here. They don't take fall damage, by the way. Dude, come on. Okay. One more. He's ripe for picking.
You'll have to sprint hard to catch up, but jumping inside through the roof should be easy.
He is lying. Jumping through this truck is frustrating as hell. Because he can't freaking catch up to the bloody thing. There, I'm in. Got another safe to crack. There we go. Replace it. Do a little switcheroo.
Great work. Team Iceland is sure to blame the Belgians. They'll be all over each other in tomorrow's dogfight.
And that's that. Back to the safe house. Getting Murray. Okay, Murray mission. Frame Team Iceland.
Just have Sly pick the lock to the door and steal the thing.
This is a delicate business. We're trying to frame Team Iceland for a crime they haven't committed. If there's any evidence of their door being forced, people might believe that they're innocent.
Man, you've gotten devious over the years. So, how are we supposed to get inside?
There are some sewer pipes beneath town that should connect up with the ventilation system of the hotel. Sly scrounged a raft for the trip, but be careful. Other pilots have caused trouble down there in the past, and the Baron is sure to have set up some security.
I get to row a boat? Nautical!
Alright, boat time. Probably my favorite job in the game, maybe? Don't know. But, keep pressing, X and you'll get there. Come on, Murray. So, I was watching a Hat in Time trailer today. If you guys don't know what a Hat in Time is, it's a 3D platformer similar to Mario 64, Banjo-Kazooie, with a little tad of Zelda Wind Waker in it. And I was watching a trailer for Chapter 3 of the game, because they're just showing... their trailers are basically just a little bit of each chapter. So they were showing a little bit of chapter 3, and I heard a conductor's voice, and it sounded like David Scully. And if you guys don't know who David Scully is, it's the voice of Dimitri. So I have no clue if it's official or not that David Scully is voicing this conductor, but man, it sounded just like him. Like, holy crap. I couldn't believe it. Anyway, we are here. Few fun platforming pieces. Ah, balls. Make sure you're careful over here. Paraglider comes in handy. Let's head into that building. Okay, so they put up a bunch of traps. Don't run in here. But just navigate around all the traps and everything. You're probably going to set at least one of them off. But we got their helmet. Head back to Murray, however. Did that very nice. So we gotta do this just one more time. It's cool though, I do enjoy this little platforming segment. Yeah, so the current change. I swear, he goes faster in the PS3 and Vita versions. Oh no. Well, I just took some damage by mistake. This is a new course just to go through. Keep pressing X. It's tedious. Could sneak through here. Just a bit, but make sure you're really tapping X. I just remembered something I want to put on my Christmas list.
Nice job. You really showed some finesse with those oars.
The Murray is, and always has been, finesse.
Yeah. You good to plant this helmet on the Belgian plane?
Can do, pal. Can do with a vengeance.
Okay, now we gotta go over there, but I will be right back. Okay, I am back. Let's, head over there. Going up. This just makes everything so much quicker. That was smooth.
place by these anchors. Destroy them and the plane should come crashing down.
Seems like these lasers might roast my hulking bulk.
True. You'll have to compact yourself using your ball move to travel safely beneath the laser grid.
Check.
You'll need to use your charged ball attack to take out the anchors. Go into ball form and quickly tap the square button to build up force. Let's try.
So come over here, get in the ball form. Make sure these things don't hit you. You gotta be glowing to hit these things and hopefully not get set on fire. It's going to happen though, because they do push you up.
Just one more excellent work. Land the Viking helmet and the Belgians are sure to blame Team Iceland.
Let's head over here and place that helmet that's on Murray's ass for some reason. And that's a job complete and video complete for me. So if you guys like the video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget we can make Sly Cooper Steel again. Tweet to Shu Yoshida on Twitter at USB. Tell me we want more Sly. Sincera wants to make it. Hopefully we'll get it soon. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.